Hello everyone. Today we are going to start with our new chapter of class 6 physics, that is matter. It is the first chapter in the book and you have already read in class 5 the solid, liquid and gases. This topic matter is a brief description about all those three states of matter, solid, liquid and gas. So in this chapter matter, it is divided into some subtopics. So the first one is, it will be the definition of matter. The second part, it will be the volume and density. Then the three states of matter, that is solid, liquids and gas. Based on these three states of matter, why do we define these three states of matter in terms of shape, size, fluidity, intermolecular space, rigidity? These are the properties by which we can distinguish between the solid, liquid and gases. So first we are going to do the first part, that is definition of matter. Matter, as you know, anything in this space occupies some volume. Anything, any substance in this space occupies some volume and it has some mass. For example, this pen that I am holding or anything around you, you can see it occupies some space. And hence, matter is any substance that occupies space and has some mass, that known as the matter. So, we are discussing the three different states of matter, the solid, liquids and gases. These are the three states of matter. Now, the second subpart, that is the volume. What is volume? For example, a liquid, it holds the liquid. When you are keeping a liquid in a container, that means the volume of that container is what? The volume of the liquid. Similarly, this pen, whatever the volume, that means this mass that here it occupies the space, that is only known as the volume. Now, we distinguish solid, liquid and gases in terms of shape and size. Now, first, let's start with what is solid. Anything that has definite shape. For example, you have your desk, table in front of you, the fan, the doors, the window. It has got some definite shape and the shape is not changing. So, this is known as the solid. Now, in case of liquid, how do you define liquid? Liquid has got no definite shape. It has only the shape of the container in which it is kept. For example, you are taking a kettle and you are filling the kettle with water. Now the water, the volume of the water, that means that liquid is equal to the volume of the container. Now you are pouring that water from the kettle to a glass. Now the volume of the liquid becomes equal to the volume of the glass. So in case of liquid, you do not have any definite shape, but you have a specific volume. That volume is nothing but the volume of the container in which it is kept. Now for gases, what you have, wherever you keep some gas, for example this room, have you sprayed any time a perfume at one corner of the room? You will see that perfume is spreading all over the room. How is that possible? Because that perfume is going throughout this room. Similarly, in case of steam, when you are heating a water, it becomes the third state of matter, that is gas. It is also has no definite volume and it is containing in the whole room. It is covering only. So, first part, that is the property shape and size, that we have already discussed. What is the shape of the liquid? How can we define the shape of a solid and gas? Solid has definite shape, liquid has no definite shape. It occupies the volume of the container, and gas, it also has no definite shape and size. Fluidity. Now the second term is fluidity. Now if you keep a solid in one place, you cannot see that the solid is flowing in that surface. But if you keep a liquid, you can see that the liquid is flowing on the surface. And in case of gas, we see that liquid, the gas is flowing on the surface. How it is now the intermolecular space, the third sub part is intermolecular space. Now you can see these three figures. The first figure is of the solid, the second figure is of the liquid, and the third is for the gases. Now here, what is molecule? Molecule is nothing but this, when you are having any solid, this solid is made up of small molecules. These are known as the small molecules. So if this is a solid, this is filled up of molecules. The molecules make a solid. Now the distance between two molecules in a solid is very near to each other. There is no space between these molecules. But in case of liquid, you can see there is so much space between two molecules. And in the third case, in case of the gases, you can see there are lots of spaces. So you can see that solid here is densely populated. That means there are so many molecules. So the molecules are densely populated here. So the density is maximum in case of solid. In case of liquid, you can see the molecules are a bit far from each other. Hence the density in case of liquid is less than that of the solid. But as you can see in the gas, there is so much space between the molecules. So here, in case of gases, you can see a lot of space between the molecules. Hence, the density here is minimum, right? So, and rigidity. Rigidity, the more the density, the more it is rigid. So, because their molecules are very close enough, they have between them, the bonding is very high. So, when the bonding is very high between them, so it is called rigid. Hence solid has the maximum rigidity, the liquid has rigidity less than that of the solid, and the gases have rigidity less than that of the liquid. So here we have discussed the different properties of solids, liquids and gases. So as a work, homework, you will study what is matter, the definition, what is volume, density, and the two properties in case of solids, liquids and gas, two or three properties you will read, and the comparison that I have discussed now, you will read those comparisons, and the brief discussion I will do it in the class. Thank you so much.